Hey, we get one press release on our podcast.
Oh my gosh. Now we need hair. Our podcast gets seen one time at a gas station, and now here you go.
Do I need to touch up?
You look good.
No. Give him a touch up.
And Matt, the redness on your face, it looks cute.
Natural blush.
Yeah, exactly.
It's called rosacea. Okay.
Remember when we were on that cruise and that's when you had your
my psoriasis.
Your psoriasis.
Oh my, he had to make it known. He had to tell everybody on that ship.
You're coming up with a situation, like imagine a bunch of girls like are making fun of you.
Yeah.
And I just come in front of you and I'm just like, hey, don't make fun of my friend. He has psoriasis. Matt. Let's go.
Yeah, Matt, let's go. Come with us. Unlike them, we have class or something like that.
Before we continue, let's hit that intro, baby. It's Coffee Taco, baby. Yeah.
I never know what you guys do every time we're doing our dance.
You guys have your own thing going on. We have to figure our shit out. We come up with something new every time.
They do the juice and the funny. We start grinding on each other.
Boy, smile here. Look over here. Say hello.
Hey, huns.
One press release. One press release.
I know. Jesus.
Smile for the camera.
Look over here.
Look over here. Zane Heath Unfiltered. Oh, my God. People have been saying they've seen us at gas stations on the TV screens that pops up when you're pumping gas.
Yeah. So
I heard that. Why didn't they take a picture?
I think because it happens so fast. You know when you're watching the TV screen?
Make sure you're Zane Heath Unfiltered. What are you pumping? Unleaded?
So Spotify is starting to release video on their platform, which is huge. Like there's never been video like on Spotify for podcasts, and they're using Heath and I,
and we're
Heath
the first one, guys.
We're the guinea pig.
Woo! We are the
I've
experimental
never been so proud to be the guinea pig.
Guys, welcome back to Zane and Heath Unfiltered. I'm Zane
and I'm Heath, and then we got Matt and Mariah over here, our lovely colleagues.
Yeah, but they're very unimportant. It's like they're kind of like the side pieces.
Chime in every once in a while.
Yeah,
the peanut gallery.
We gotta start pushing them out more, you know. Right. Like, who cares?
I was thinking about giving them their own camera, but then I was like, you know what?
That's why no. You gotta share. Okay, should we give them their own cameras?
No,
we should.
No.
Oh my God! When we have guests, this is gonna be a mess.
Yeah, and should we have a moving camera too? Like, like someone moving
the one that the crane that rolls across
the crane and the floor trolley.
The guy that's sitting
There's
in the seat behind it
for hours.
Babe, we keep working hard. We'll get there.
Who would be our first guest?
I don't
Miss
know.
Juicy Baby.
We keep joking
baby.
About that. Yeah.
Bad Baby would be a perfect first guest.
Oh, she would never say yes to us.
Guys, we're back. Whether you're on your way to you're home. You're staying
room.
Home.
It must be tough listening to podcasts.
Yeah. I couldn't imagine sitting like in a chair or a bed just.
Yeah, so we should always be thinking of the best times to be listening to podcasts. It's when you're washing dishes,
folding laundry.
Yep.
I've done that before.
Mowing the lawn, but it might be kind of loud. Can you listen to music
cooking.
When you're
oh, yeah.
cooking?
Cooking.
Because cooking always takes like 45 minutes, you know, like the full meal takes about 45 minutes. Oh, it's like a perfect
Zane just started cooking, so he's excited.
Cooks one meal.
Guys, once you find like a good meal, you just want to make it all the time and you just obsess over it.
Yeah, it's so fun. You just pop it in the microwave, 45 seconds.
No,
done.
No. I did my part. I went to the store, got ground turkey, mashed it all together with some onion cilantro, and made turkey burgers. It was delicious.
He did
use
do
my
it.
Griddle too.
He did do it. He didn't know how his that he had an oven light above it though.
It ended up being really good. And now I make it all the time.
Nice.
So
it's the one meal he cooks it every day.
I want to because it's so good. It tastes it's healthy too.
He cooked a turkey burger.
Is a turkey burger is a turkey burger not like a really fancy thing to make? It's fancy to me.
It's a very Zane question. Yeah. Like, is a turkey? It depends on how fancy you make it.
I'm not making fucking baked salmon tortellini, fucking with a nice green salad. I don't know how to do that.
He couldn't even make something up fancy in his head.
What would be considered a fancy meal to you?
Like a chicken cordon bleu.
Yeah,
something like that. Or
yeah.
What is that?
Exactly.
People are thinking a HelloFresh ad is coming, but it's not.
Not this time.
No, not this time, baby. We are in a pandemic.
That
times
would have
are
been
hard.
A really good time. Right. You couldn't make one of those? Well, make sure. Oh, man. That would be funny.
Did you guys, obviously, you heard about Elon Musk's new baby and the name that him and Grimes decided to
yes.
call their baby.
So, how is it pronounced? X?
It's X. So, the name X. is X. I watched the interview and I forgot what AE. It's pronounced
Ash. It's pronounced Ash.
Ash.
Right. X Ash 12.
And then A12 is Elon Musk's favorite plane, and that's the Lockheed. Yeah. So it's like X-Ash Lockheed, I think.
People are woke.
But I love that those two souls have really found each other. Like, I bet they can geek out on the same type of things.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, sure. Big fan. Big fan.
Name one Grimes song.
No, I'm saying big fan of their relationship. Big fan. Like, they seem very good together, like quirky.
Name five of his inventions.
Tesla Model M3, a Tesla Roadster, Tesla
Roadster.
PayPal.
What else has he made that's not like part of Tesla? Like
boring,
what? PayPal.
Boring company, SpaceX.
He made PayPal?
Yeah. PayPal.
Oh, wow.
When he was really young and then sold it for a shit ton of money.
Oh, wow.
Did you ever have like a friend who had like a really bad business idea?
No, that was not our
community. I had this one idea. It was a food truck app.
Okay.
Fuck off.
I was like
it's basically what just
it was,
Uber
it was,
Eats,
it was like... when I was super into like wanting to come out with my own food truck.
Okay.
And I was like, you can look up like a restaurant, but like you can't, like sometimes there'll be a food truck at a park that you really like, and you'll go to it because you know they have good tacos or good chicken, whatever it is, but you can never like know their location. But if it was like a map that popped up that showed what food truck was in your area and where it was, because a lot of people like eating at food trucks.
And for that reason, I'm out.
Nobody's ever sitting there and going, I'm hungry. Let's go to the food truck. Because food trucks are cool because you see it on the spot. You drive by and you're like, ooh, let's stop there.
Remember when I named one of the food trucks, an Italian one called Spaghetti About It?
And she said, Pasta La Vista.
That's good. Pasta La Vista.
She's clever. She's got the brains behind it all.
Right. You're going to be big one day. I can feel it.
What was the idea you were going to talk about, though?
Basically, the guy was like, yo, I have this idea for like an app. So when I'm running, I really like it when the beat is matching up to
your footsteps.
My footsteps. So I want to create this app that creates music for you that syncs up with the
your
way
pace.
That you run your pace.
Zane's song would like, be.
But like he was like all about it, and I was like, how are you gonna do this? Like it.
Yeah, where do you start?
Like, where do you start? Like, so what do you... you don't even know about the like techniques of putting in, like, pacers in your shoe and then creating a software for it. And I go, there's not even a want or demand. I'm not saying I'm a pessimistic friend. I'm just kind of realistic.
I've never heard somebody throughout their day be like, gosh, I wish my music...
Yeah, it's just
something
footsteps. Fun that you kind of like, oh, that'd be cool if that happened. But
I know,
it's very intricate to like, come up with something.
All of my most people pick a song that's faster paced, so they run faster to it.
And it's easier to pick a song than to hook your shoes up to your phone and like...
I think we were just stoned and we were in college. Yeah. And that's...
God, I used to have some good inventions.
I thought of one that was... we have a dish towel that's Christmas themed and we have to put it away during the season. So I thought of one that's double-sided. One is winter and the other side is spring. You know, your parents put like a spring one out, like a flower one.
Oh God, that is an Aunt Debbie invention.
You do like a flower side and then you can flip it over and it's snowflakes.
Right.
Not bad. Oh my God, it's gonna
you
be
buy one towel that's decorative but all season long.
I know, there's always that one.
It would be a Facebook hit.
It
you
would.
Tell me that it won't be.
It would.
And you have like, some really frustrated moms. Are you tired of this happening?
They would love it.
It's a waste of a towel.
I like it.
No, I like it too. I think you're on
something. Cut that out. We want to keep that. Yeah. Nobody take our idea.
Please don't take my... Please, please.
Yeah, Mariah, look it up after the podcast, Steve. That's...
I'm going to get so many messages like, it already exists.
Probably.
Why is everything existing?
Heath, trademark that shit.
But I think that's...
Oh my gosh, I forgot to tell you guys. So my grandparents, like 2 days ago, they went to go into their garage to go get into the car... And a fucking alligator was in their garage.
What?
How to get in the
like
garage?
A 5-foot alligator in their garage.
And this isn't the first time for them, right?
Oh, sorry.
No, they've had multiple. They live on a lake, so they've had multiple alligator experiences. But my grandpa was walking out into the garage, and all of a sudden, behind like his like chair out there was a fucking alligator.
How big?
Five foot.
Oh, what?
That would...
How do you get him out?
I don't know. They just like shoot him off.
It's crazy. Cram. It's like there was a video that I saw on Twitter where it was an alligator just walking on the street and it had hundreds and thousands of likes. And I'm like...
We see this shit all the time.
We see this shit all the time. How is this like... Why is this like such a crazy video? I've seen crazier shit with my own eyes with alligators.
Yeah, right. I showed Heath a video of an alligator that was... I swear it was the size of a dinosaur. Like massive, just strolling. And he was like, yeah. He's like, what are you, like, how is this thing walking around?
Is this, people don't see alligators where they're from. They don't even know what that shit looks like. Yeah.
But everybody that, like, hears that we're from Florida is like, oh my God, do you guys see alligators everywhere?
Everywhere.
I was on a family vacation one time.
What else is
in
new?
Florida, in Florida, Sanibel. I know.
Here we go.
And I was with my cousins. And every family vacation we had, we would play Survivor because that was like a hit TV show during the time.
Right.
And we would have like challenges.
I'm like embarrassed for you, but like low key jealous.
Yeah, I kind of want to go with you to a family trip and just like experience.
It's great.
This.
It's a ball. anyways. One of our challenges for Survivor that day, so we stayed at this like resort condominium place, and there was like a pond, and it was in Florida, and there was this alligator that would like hang out by the water sometimes, like a small one, maybe 3 or 4 foot, and it was just, it would just sit there. Well, we would go and look at the alligator, just us as kids, and we saw some like older adults, like people our age. And they were like drunk or whatever, and they were like going up to the alligator and touching the leg or whatever. And I made this stupid decision where I go, okay, guys, Survivor challenge for this, for alligator. Today is touch the alligator's tail. So we all took turns, and I can't believe these adults didn't stop us at all.
And I mean, you said they're all right.
How old,
right,
how old
now,
are you?
I'd be like, yeah, let's do it.
10, 9.
And these adults just let you like go by the elevator?
None of them were like, what are you kids doing? Don't do what we're doing. They were like cracking up that we were like.
Yo, that's me as an adult. I just want to see what happens.
So,
I want to see what fucking goes.
So I touched the alligator's tail. My cousin touched the tail and another cousin did. I'm pretty sure it was like 3 of us. And then all the cousins, we went back to like the pool area or whatever. One of the cousins went up to my uncle and was like, Matt told us we had to touch the alligator's tail, and they did it. And my uncle was
just
like,
"Just a family of rats."
Excuse me, he did what? And then he pulled me like into this little gift shop area.
Beat your ass.
And he had a—I remember he had a basketball in his hand, and he goes, "Did you touch an alligator?"
he gives you dap. He's like,
"No." And I said, "Yeah." He then took the basketball and bounced it right off my forehead. You know when like a basketball hits your nose, you like immediately start crying.
Yeah.
And you know you're in trouble and you just feel like an idiot. And I sat there in that gift shop crying.
Well deserved. Well deserved.
But props, you got some balls, kid.
Mm-hmm. I did. Basketballs.
Okay, so we've had our fair share of break-ins with our cars on the street, okay?
Oh, my God. Don't tell me you have another one.
So yesterday, we were out grocery shopping. This was, like, at night. We're like, we're at Rite Aid.
At night.
We're there, and all of a sudden, I never thought it would happen, but, like, my alarm on my phone went off. It was just, like, bathroom guest house alarm just went off. And then 30 seconds later, balcony door went off. And I look at, like, Matt and Tom, I was like, oh my God, someone's in our house. Like,
because
two things just opened.
Right, right. So it looked like they went in and then went
through another one. We immediately get in the car and we start, we immediately just start fucking driving faster. We're like, fuck, we gotta get there. Like, because we wanna get there because we know, you know how intruders are. When they hear alarm, they're gonna get there as fast. So we just wanna at least catch them, just like running, just so we could get a vision of them. And
but what was funny is like, we're like so excited. We're like, let's go, let's go. And then as we're getting to the house, we start slowing down. Because we're like, well, wait. What are we getting ourselves into?
It was actually embarrassing. So we get in front of our house and we're just sitting there and watching our house. And I look at, we had a bat in the car. We have like a bat in the car. So me, Todd, and Matt, we're like, we wanted to get out, but we're like, fuck, like we've seen too many movies. So anybody, this person could have a fucking gun. You know, we're just
You lose that battle.
I have a security system where somebody like comes out when it goes off. So on our way there, they call and they go, they were talking so slow, like nothing was going on. They're like, hi, sir, did somebody, one of your alarms go off. Is everybody okay? I was like, no. Like, we're driving to our house. We're getting there as fast as possible. We need you there.
Sir, I need you to slow down.
It's crazy.
No,
that
it's
hard people. Time.
It sounded like he was getting a foot massage.
Yeah, it's crazy. And we get there. We're there for, I'm not lying, 10 fucking minutes. And then this person that works for the company shows up. And.
Oh, no.
And she gets out of the car and she does not look like she wants to do anything.
She waddles up the steps.
No, it was
like,
it was crazy.
Going?
So we go up there, we walk in, everything seems normal, and she comes in just so slow behind us. She comes in, she's like, "Damn, y'all have a nice house." And we're like,
"What?"
That's what she has to say to her.
First thing she says, and we're like, thank you. Can you like
scope it out?
Can you scope out the place for us, please? Like the alarm has been going off, and she's walking around, and it's her first night. Like it was unbelievable. She barely checks the place. She like, mind you, like it was like we were like three guys who could have done it, but like again, like we are not. We don't have like anything
trained
to keep us safe.
Right.
Yeah. And
what's weird is one of the notifications was bathroom GB, which is like the guest bathroom.
That was the first one that went off.
And I have motion sensors in my bathroom.
He's got a spy kit, cool. You know, the little like.
The door just is real sensitive to the wind.
If it's not fully closed, it's going to.
It's going to open. Yeah. But that's what we're pretty sure happened. But then why did the bathroom alarm go off? And then who entered it? Like. We don't know.
Was this around the same time as the guy that was in David's backyard recently?
Yes. Because when we get there.
Because that was a couple days ago.
When we get there, this person, these kids, there's three boys in a car, drives by coincidentally at the same time.
Weird.
It was just really weird. He got their license plate, so we're good.
Yeah, so if it was you and that Mustang, we got your license plate.
Yeah, we're actually gonna check the cameras tomorrow because I forgot to do it today. But tomorrow we're gonna check the cameras and see if this car like stops in front of our house.
Right.
It's just crazy. Like people do this shit to people's like houses and property. And they have no idea. There's cameras fucking everywhere, and you will get caught.
We actually have a friend that just caught on their security camera a guy coming and stealing packages. But multiple times, and then this time stole another one, but also pissed on the door.
What?
As they were stealing the package.
Oh, I didn't hear about this.
Yeah, I thought he just threw eggs.
No.
He threw eggs and he peed on the house and stole packages.
Yes.
Right? All caught on security.
Is it the same person?
Yeah.
Dude.
Different times though.
The balls you have to have, and you know there's a camera at the front door. And
right.
This kid wasn't wearing a mask either.
Very weird.
Oh, but I've done my fair share of crimes,
peeing on
though.
People's
peeing
doors?
No.
I've done my fair share of crimes like as a kid.
What's the worst crime you've ever committed?
Oh, God, this is so embarrassing. It's so embarrassing. But like, you know, we got to talk about like bad shit that we've done.
Uh-huh.
Back when I was a kid, I was probably in fifth grade, sixth grade. Well, how old were you in sixth grade? Like
11.
11 years old. I would like sneak out and oh my God, I'm going to regret this.
Uh-oh. No, go ahead. Say it.
This is like me being a bad role model to like people listening.
I mean, but that's life, dude.
Yeah,
kids do bad shit.
Yeah, you're
kids
right. You're right. So
have fun.
I would go around and like open cars.
I thought it was like a little innocent crime.
No,
that's
no.
a crime.
I used to steal like a Kit Kat from a gas station.
I am not. I'm not excusing myself from anything. By the way, the most I stole was like a pocket knife. I was not going to use this pocket knife to hurt anybody.
do his next crime.
And for my next crime.
I ran from the cops when I was a kid. On foot. Like
baby.
Headlights. Headlights on me. And I got away.
Dude, nice. Jeff would be so proud of us. Yeah, what are we talking about? Jeff has done so much bad shit.
Right.
What am I doing?
When we were... Oh, this is terrible. Once again, guys, never would encourage this. This is stupid.
Cut that out. Who cares?
So when we were younger, middle school, we would sneak out at night. And there was... The edge of the neighborhood was this big brick wall that faced the highway. And we would hide behind the wall... That was also like in an alleyway.
Uh-huh.
So there was this huge pecan tree that was by the wall. And we would get on top of trash cans. I didn't do this, guys. I didn't.
Oh, you're fucking
no,
right.
No, I was the kid at the
sleepover. If you're going to come clean right now, come all
But
the
you
way
guys
clean.
Know me. I was the kid at the sleepover who was like, this is a bad idea.
That's
we
like
shouldn't
a
be doing
shower
this.
With
I had
a shower cap
same
on.
Thing, but
come
guess what? You
clean.
Tagged along. You tagged along because
I did tag
you
along.
To feel
well,
accepted.
I wanted to feel accepted. You're exactly right, Zane.
Exactly.
But I did not do this, but my two good friends did. They would stand
and
there
still
and
good friends
throw
now.
Pecans at right at cars when they were driving by, and cars would like stop, and like there was also like a toll thing right there where they would like run the toll and these cars would like freak out.
This was on the highway.
It was on, we were in an alley behind a brick wall of a neighborhood that would look at the highway.
Oh, okay.
It was like an access road, like where people okay. would get off. We did it 2 weekends. Then on the third weekend, we decided to do it again. But this time, the cops were prepared. We start throwing
it. Because it only takes one call.
And all of a sudden, we see a huge, big light come. And we're like, oh, this is like a big 18-wheeler. And we look over the brick wall. And there is a cop there with a massive spotlight flashing it on us. And that cop probably saw our little heads pop up,
right?
And pop right back down. Suddenly, down the alley, you hear whoop whoop. A whole cop car comes with its lights flashing, just book it, scatter. I ran my tush off. I ran so hard. By the time I got to like one of my friend's house in the neighborhood that I just knew, he wasn't even with us, I got to the side of his house and I just puked my guts out. And I wasn't drunk or anything. My nerves and adrenaline.
Yeah, just
so
the endurance funny. Just.
Dude, you're that one dude in a scary movie. Like everything scares him, he just pukes all the time.
That's exactly what happened. And we managed We managed to scatter and all get back to my friend's house.
Nobody got caught.
Untouched, nothing. And we were in my friend, he had this balcony that could like overlook like the kind of the neighborhood. And we watched the cop cars all night, like scan all up and down the alleys with the spotlights. And they never caught us to this day.
I'm gonna be completely
real. I didn't do it.
I'm gonna defend myself.
You said you did it.
I mean, I was part of it, but I didn't throw anything.
Ooh, you know what that is? That's
guilty by association.
Excuses. And you know what that is?
That's another one.
And you know, when we're doing our thing, we weren't putting people's lives in danger.
To the folks listening, know that I'm innocent, but
he said, I did not throw that
pick in. If the glove does not fit, you must acquit.
I was just going to make a quick comment.
Yeah.
When Mariah doesn't talk for more than 5 minutes, can I chime in?
I just want to make a quick comment just for other people that are listening that may be like at that age, just in case. I'm not trying to make myself sound better or shame you guys, but I was the kid that didn't follow peer pressure or anything.
Oh, fuck off.
No, but I'm just saying because I felt
scared of her parents. Like,
I was scared of my parents, but I felt more embarrassed that I wasn't following the cool kids. I wasn't like, I need to do it so I can feel accepted.
But you did feel like you were missing out though.
I still had friends. Like everyone was still friends with me. I just want to get invited to parties because they were like, oh, she doesn't like drink or anything like that. So,
subtle flex.
Don't feel like you need to follow the crowd. That's all I'm saying.
Take Mariah's advice, baby.
Trust me, because I had a lot of friends who did follow the crowd, and you know where it ended them? County jail.
It is crazy that we think when we, like, as kids, when we're doing this shit, we thought it, like, just our mind is completely somewhere else. Where, like, we think this is cool.
What's scary is, I think back to shit that I did when I was younger, and I was like, I could have fucked my entire life up.
What, like as bad as, like, what Matt and I have done, like, what's something that you've done? Because I don't think I've ever heard of anything.
Oh,
I've done.
Just stupid shit like that, like drugs, just being dumb. Like,
have you ever, like, committed a crime like we have?
Like, when I was younger, I stole a little, you know, those, like, dip tan looking things of beef jerky from 7-Eleven. I think I was, like, 10 years old. And I just, like, put one in my pocket. And, like,
I felt super
guilty afterwards. And, like, I just, like.
When it comes to stealing, I 100% believe in karma when it comes to stealing. Because,
dude.
Yep. Hundo P.
Did I tell you about the time where I found a bunch of cash on the road?
Yes.
Wait, okay.
Oh, you don't remember this day?
This is, like, after this day, I was like, this shit is, karma is real. So, this was when we were living out here. Carly and Aaron lived in that apartment.
Yeah, yeah.
And I was on the way to their house, and I was looking for parking. I was driving around, circling, and I circle back around, and all of a sudden, cash is just flying on the street. 20s, 50s, and 100s. I couldn't believe it. I stop.
I couldn't believe it.
Oh, my God.
I get out of my car, and I'm like, oh, my God. I start grabbing all the cash.
Are people grabbing it, too?
No. This is just me.
I just picked one of those money machines.
No, completely empty.
Right, the hurricane.
Sticky.
Yeah.
It was. No, it was. I was the only person on the street. I was the only person in my car. I was the only person there. And this cash just came out of nowhere.
I'm picturing, like, a plane going down that's, like, got, like, money laundered. Like, we got to lose the load. We're out of gas.
And no, like, it was exactly like that, because the way this money was flying was like an act of God. Somebody was testing me. That's
I believe
what it seemed
it.
Like.
I believe it.
So this cash is flying around. I pick up all the cash. I have a little bit of heart. I have about 5% of heart to look around to see if anybody dropped it, but I didn't give too much time. I gave about 15 seconds. I grabbed Lakasha and went like this, went in my Jeep, and I kept driving looking for a parking spot because I was going to Carly and Aaron.
How much cash were we talking?
$400.
Wait, what?
$400. This was back when, like, I was, like, you know,
and Ethan I'm, and I were I'm living. I'm gonna be real with you, like, finding money, no matter what, is the greatest feeling. If it's a dollar on the ground, something about finding money.
I know.
Now when I find money, the first thing I think of is, this is somebody else's money. This, is, sure. This is how we all think now. But back then, baby, I was living, paycheck to paycheck off Vine money. This was rent. Yeah. So I took it and then I kept driving to find a spot. I parked, I went into Carly and Aaron's house and I went, guys, I found $400. We all got so excited. We went out. I took him out to a fancy dinner.
Yeah. Did we have FaceTime back then? I can't even remember.
I don't think we even used FaceTime.
Nobody used FaceTime, but I remember this day where you then messaged me and was like, I found $400 on the ground.
Yeah.
And it was a shit ton of money. But you were like, but I'm going to take Carly and Aaron out for a dinner. And I was a little pissed.
Matt, we went to the restaurant where that comedian that was like the Matt Denham. What restaurant was she talking about? Because that's the restaurant we went to.
Maggiano's.
We went to Maggiano's.
Is that a fancy spot?
Yeah.
It's
like, no, it's fancy for us. It's like
an upgrade from Olive
Outback.
Garden.
Okay.
Or Outback.
Olive Garden, it's Italian, Zane.
He said, I got the blooming onion.
No, but like Olive Garden is so like just family Italian. Maggiano's is like very like Roadhouse. It's like very dark, very like candle.
It's like a BJ's.
BJ's. It's a high-end BJ's. That's
but it's
great,
dark and it's nice.
BJ's is high-end.
So I pay for the bill. We have a really nice meal. The next day, I go to Carly and Aaron's again. My car gets towed. Guess how much?
$400.
$400.
Oh, I just got chills.
Exactly $400 to get my Jeep back. Why was it towed? No reason. No, was not street cleaning. It was not street cleaning because it was in the middle of the day.
It was the tow guy's dough.
This is fucking karma.
But was anybody around when the money was blowing?
No, it wasn't.
But what are you supposed to do? Who found the money?
I know,
whose is it?
But, like, I don't know. For some reason, I feel like that was some spirit playing a joke on me. Like, you know, like just having a little bit of fun with me.
Right.
I don't know.
I used to steal my parents' money.
Oh, I would, like, how much? How much?
Not
actually.
Much. They, okay.
I would steal quarters all the time
bad.
From their quarter.
I was bad.
Portable.
Right. We had a jar in the kitchen counter.
Like, oh, okay. So that's how I took it.
It was a fish, right? This big little fish bowl. Super tacky. But it was just full of quarters, dimes. Just
you take all the quarters, right?
Such a big bowl of money. And it was right around the time I got mixed up with the wrong crew. And they were smoking Camel Crushes. So they would all go smoke Camel Crushes. And I would like try to like show up with my own pack.
You're like, can I bum one? They're like, you got to buy yourself a box.
Right. And you had to like prove yourself. You know what I mean? You had to show up with a pack of cigarettes.
How'd you get the cigarettes?
So I would go into the fishbowl and I would just pick quarter after quarter, put it in my pocket. And then I would ride my bike to the gas station and go buy a pack of Camel Crushes.
You know what's so funny? Our parents 100% knew that we were taking these quarters.
They had to.
Because they're filling up this fucking jar. You see when it's empty. Right. They're not taking these cents out of the jar. I think they had that jar out for us to take.
And as like
honestly,
a helper.
Because they weren't using these fucking quarters
no,
and dimes.
They sat there.
That.
They never cashed it. They didn't go to Coinstar.
Because they had a fucking they had a little card. Bucket. They used a card. They weren't paying shit with cash. I think they were.
It's a communal change.
Exactly. But like, you know, they're not going to tell you, hey, take whatever money you want.
Right.
They're just going to let you sneakily get it because you're not going to take a lot. You're only going to take
and
a little bit.
And you also wouldn't ask for a couple bucks. So
exactly.
Like,
that was just their way of giving you money.
It was cigarettes and Dairy Queen Blizzards.
But they did not give you those quarters to buy cigarettes.
Remember when writing checks was more normal?
Going out to dinner?
And my paying
family. I feel like writing
checks
is very normal still.
No, right no. Paying, like going out to eat and paying with a check.
Yeah.
You don't, there was a
grocery store.
Wait. People paid with checks when they went out to eat?
Yeah.
No, what?
Yes.
I've never heard of this.
All through like my childhood, we would write a check at the dinner table.
Every time my mom got in her car, where's my checkbook?
Did you ever have Enterprise City when you were a kid?
No.
It was this place we went to that was a mini town. And
aww.
In the week preparing the, your
baby,
class.
Oh, baby, that's Wanna Do City.
That's what I literally just
wanna
said.
Wanna Do City.
Was it like a
kids sim? Can do what they wanna do, yeah.
Hey.
What was like a simulation of like a city and they taught you how to use a checkbook and pay for things?
Everything.
And, yes.
You could pick whatever job you wanted. They
Wait,
had, like,
I learned
little,
that.
Oh, you went to jail?
Yes.
And they would make one of the bars rubber so you can escape jail and they would have to catch you.
Wait, was I did there that the, in school.
That's what
it was. It was awful to like teach kids that they can escape jail. And like
that's terrible.
That you could get out that easily.
But did you got? Was it like? Was there like a grass area where like if you stepped on the grass you got a ticket?
No.
I remember it. So I want to describe this place to the people. Picture like a Disneyland, but like indoors in a big building and set up for kids. There's different shops. You know, there's like the city hall, the jail. I was a radio DJ. I was the DJ. There's like an arcade, a t-shirt shop, cafe, food place, everything. And everybody gets all a whole bunch of jobs.
It's crazy that we thought that there was nothing like Wanna Do City. We thought we were the only people that had Wanna Do City. Yeah. And I think there was a couple other locations, but we didn't think there was anything like that. And apparently there was.
I never got to go. My parents never treated me.
You know what? I'm surprised they don't have like something like that because it was very interactive and like adult. Because adults would work in each station and you would teach kids how to do shit. We need that shit now more than ever. Like because kids don't like we don't know how to do shit. Like
no,
I feel
we
like
need to be teaching kids taxes, mortgage,
exactly.
Loans.
But Wanna Do City, baby, teach them how to do taxes at Wanna Do City.
Do you think we don't teach that to kids because it's like too sensitive of a subject?
No, it's not at all.
Stupid to make them. Not know how to do normal things like that.
Who said that school is literally teaching you how to be in debt? All it does is prepare you to be in debt.
Not that it forces you, but it normalizes the whole process of
getting a loan for school and like being in debt. Like it's
right,
like,
and it doesn't teach you things that you can use outside of school.
Yeah,
it's like
the whole education system needs to be completely changed and needs to be like catered to what people actually need to fucking like learn as an adult.
Right,
because it's not enough of that.
No,
like,
for
why
sure.
Why am I learning the Pythagorean theorem when I could be learning about taxes and how to like write checks and
or how
to store my
or
bills.
How to invest money or do anything? Like
because there's like a bit of mystique where they don't want the masses to know everything.
No, for
there's
sure.
like Makes something sense. Behind that where it's
100%.
Like 100%. Wait, what's on the list or?
Do we have a game or something?
Random. So what's the wrong answer game?
You ask them a question and they have to give you the wrong answer. It sounds dumb, but rapid fire question. Like what brand is your shirt can bring out some hilarious creativity for the right type of person.
Cool.
So you have to ask Zane questions, but you have to answer them wrong.
Okay. Cool. Bubba, what's my name?
Joe.
Oof.
Who the fuck is Joe?
Zane, what color is your hair?
Pink.
Well, what color are your eyes?
Blue.
Where are you from?
Lebanon.
No, because you kind of are from
Lebanon.
I'm
not from there, though.
What did you study in college?
American psychology.
American? American psychology.
That was me trying to come up with
something. That sounds
interesting. It's just dumb people.
Wait, that sounds like the history of psychology. I kind of like that.
Yeah, you like that? You like that answer? I'm really good at this
game.
Right.
I don't know. It sounds
interesting.
Okay. Heath, what shirt are you wearing?
Blue.
No.
Oh, my God. Sorry. All right.
What color are your teeth?
Right.
Right.
Wait, what?
Right.
I was going to say red. But
where is that shirt from?
Cuba.
No, you got to answer.
Well, it was from Miami. Texas.
Where's your mom from?
Texas.
Oh, you wanted to say it so bad.
She couldn't think of anything. She just went,
you just took
that. My toes curled up so. Where's your mom from?
We want to tell the truth so bad. We just want to answer
Texas.
Zane, what's your sister's name?
Joanna.
Oh.
This is funny. Hit me.
When's your birthday?
April 7th.
2 days after.
It was a lie.
Okay.
When is your coffee dropper?
Oh, shit. Ouch.
2023. Fuck, that was the truth.
No, that's not fair. Guys, there's definitely... I feel like... Have we talked about this?
We haven't talked about it in a long time. Guys, the coffee's ready. The coffee's made.
We're just on a halt because of this whole quarantine situation. There's been just...
These things take time.
Yeah.
These things take a really long time.
Because, guys, literally, logo is everything when it comes to our brand. And we want to make it perfect. Yeah. We want to make it fun, energetic.
And,
we want to make it...
Right. And you guys are very involved. You don't have, like, a team that's like, we're going to do this. And
this
you're like,
is
okay,
what it is,
sure.
And follow it.
Right. You guys are very, very involved. And you want it to be as good as it possibly
and
can.
And even if we do let other people involve it, it's just not good enough because we want it. it to come from us. We want it to come from what we like and what we think you guys would like. And
right. The coffee flavors we have gotten dialed in. Everything's pretty much ready to go. We're working on the packaging right now. And we've seen a lot of things, and it's not up to something that we feel we want to put out yet.
Yeah. But we think we like it, and then we just don't like it in the end.
Right.
And we want to change it.
It's almost there. There's stuff that we got to tweak. Right. And
this isn't like a merch t-shirt. Right. Yeah. This is a
it's our life. It's right. like, it's something that we really want to be involved life. In. And
can we play this next game?
Wow. Yeah,
damn, okay. God. You know that what? Side just makes us feel like shit whenever we're
no
talking about something.
No coffee for them.
Oh, God. Go ahead. Just okay. start the game.
This one is called Mind Meld. Okay. You both count to three, and then both of you blurt out a word.
Oh,
example.
Wait, Heath and I play this.
You gotta get the same word.
Heath and I have said the same word twice.
Okay.
We're good at this.
Okay. All right, ready? But just to set it up, though, both of you blurt out a word. For example, you say hat and you say army. You then read each other's nonverbals, do it again with the goal to converge on the same word. So the next time you might both say helmet, because army.
My brain
hat.
Is not quick enough
it's
for this game.
All right, Zane, ready?
Because I'm going to go with hat and army.
No.
Wait, Zane, that was an example.
We're both going to say two random words.
Two random words. It doesn't matter about them
and
being the
same.
And then
go off of
and
those words.
And then once you hear those two words, we're going to go one, two, three. Say another
Got
word.
It. Okay, okay.
And
right.
try to get the same word. All right,
let's
ready?
Do it.
One, two, three, coffee.
Brownie.
One.
Wait, what'd you say?
Coffee.
What'd you say?
Brownie.
Okay, keep going. Come on.
Are you guys asleep?
Now in...
One, two, three,
mocha.
Chocolate.
Keep going.
Whoa.
Close.
One, two, three,
coffee.
Caramel. One, two, three, cream.
Hazelnut.
One, two, three,
milk.
Oh, my goodness.
All right, Matt, you want to try?
Yes.
Wait, you know what Heath and I do? We do one, two, three, and we say, like, say you said coffee, and I said stool. Then we have to figure out how to get from stool to coffee.
Right.
Like a stool is something you sit on. You sit inside a
Take
cafe.
A shit.
Coffee
makes
cafe.
You shit.
Right.
The thing is that stool is shit.
Mariah, the thing is that you do that, but you don't know where he's going with his word. That's like the hard
that's
part.
That's why
about
you have
that.
To like
no, that's
try
the
to
point.
Like.
That's the funny part.
Hmm.
All right, ready?
Let's try it again.
One, two, three,
hat.
Cup. One, two,
three, merch.
One, two, three, shirt.
Fuck, sorry.
Silence.
You see, I don't know if you're going off my word or your word.
Both. That's you gotta find the middle ground.
Okay. You gotta feel it out. Okay. Feel it out. Ready?
Okay.
I can't. This is too much.
One, two, three, couch. Okay.
Okay.
One, two, three, tripod.
One, two, three, mic.
Oh, man.
One, two, three, podcast.
Mariah,
one,
come on.
One, two, three, microphone. Oh, hey!
I said it.
Podcast should have came out like three times before that.
Yeah, okay. Well, I think we're just...
All right, one more.
We're
all
like this.
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Hold on, wait.
I'm probably cutting this
okay.
shit. It's annoying.
One, two, three, press.
Oh! One, two, three, trees! Yeah!
Give me that.
Yeah, baby! That's two.
Good.
Two turns.
Well done. Two turns.
Whoa.
Two turns.
Oh, Matt's so jealous.
It's always a competition.
Oh, come on. You got as excited as I did. Come on.
No, I did.
That was crazy.
All right, ready?
I did.
One, two, three, table.
Oh!
Oh,
wow.
God, you playing that shit.
They go like this. They kicked themselves.
Yeah. They went like this.
Fuck out of here. Right, give me the next Come game. On. What do we got?
What does it say on game. There? You want to do start?
Very impressive.
Do you guys know what
impressive.
Star counting is?
No.
Okay. Oh, is it like Zodiac slash?
No. We're all going to count to the highest number we can randomly whenever you want. Close your eyes, and we're just going to start at one. Any of you guys can say two and add on to
oh,
it.
Oh, I love this
but
game.
We have
wait,
to,
what?
We used to play this in middle school theater.
I used to play this in my car with my siblings. Game. You close your eyes. I'm going to start. I'm going to say one. Someone else say two. But if somebody says it at the same time, we start over and see how high we can go.
Okay. Ready?
Okay. Close
Wait,
your eyes.
I still don't yeah. understand this.
Zane, just watch. Ready?
Yeah. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. Close your eyes.
Ready? One.
Two.
Three.
Four.
Five.
Five.
Oh.
Shit. So we got to start over.
Oh.
Because we said it at the same time.
Okay.
Why would you say five? You just said the number. Let us give
Zane,
us the
trust. No, it's any order. It's any
One.
Order. Two. Three.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Seven.
Eight.
Nine.
Ten.
11.
12.
13.
14.
15.
16.
17.
18.
19.
20.
21.
22.
23.
24.
25.
26.
27.
28.
29.
30.
31.
32.
33.
34.
Who said it? Wait,
I was.
That's really good.
That is real. That's really good. I felt like I knew energy. When you guys were gonna fucking say it.
In my brain, I was watching lines.
Yeah, I was like, all right, Zane. Mariah, Zane.
Damn, Mariah Zane. And that's on Unfiltered Spirits. You know what I'm saying? I'm really proud of you guys. Guys, this brings us together. I love you guys so
much. Feel
this
is like, I feel a lot closer.
I really know you guys.
We start crying off of the Star Game.
I have a random question conversation starter generator.
Cool.
Okay.
Don't we all?
What's your favorite bird?
Easy, the mockingbird.
Blue jay.
Kookaburra.
My favorite bird is a secretary bird.
I didn't even know that was a bird.
You ever seen it?
No.
Can you Google it? It's the coolest looking bird you'll ever see in
your life. Why do I feel like you made that question just so you can talk about your favorite bird?
What's your favorite bird? She means business.
Because people don't have a favorite bird. It's like, okay, what's your...
I like peacocks.
Matt, does it look like Viola Davis as a bird?
No, it looks like Tilda Swinton as a bird.
Peacock's a cool bird.
Peacocks are
male or female?
So cool.
That's,
male?
It's so good. Cliche, though.
I had a family vacation one time. We went camping, and there were these cabins, and the whole like camp resort thing had peacocks everywhere.
That's
and
cool.
They would chase us.
When I lived in Pasadena, there were peacocks all down the street.
Around
the
streets, just living
because
through the streets.
There's a bird sanctuary like 5 minutes from my old apartment. And they would just walk the streets of Pasadena.
What?
They would really just get out and just roam.
Are there peacocks in Florida?
The other day, or when I was moving out of my apartment.
Oh,
remember?
My God. So every we were getting the stuff out. Every time we would bring a piece of furniture downstairs, there'd be a different animal. There was a possum sitting on the fence
that
watching
us move.
That
was the first round. The possum was the first round.
Super nasty, creepy possum just sitting there.
We go upstairs.
Came back, and then a raccoon darted across. And we're like, what the fuck? Like, this is so weird. Go back up, grab another thing, came back down, and there was two coyotes. But like big coyotes, where it wasn't like a normal.
Mariah's always remind me of Snow White, though, so maybe that has something to do with it.
I don't know what that means.
You just summon animals? Like.
Yeah. I don't know. There's something about like.
Thank you.
You that I feel like you're connected with animals in some way.
Thank you. Nerf is very connected to me. I will brag about that.
Does he like you? It takes a long time for Nerf to like you.
He
and
really
like to
likes
actually
me.
Cuddle with
Jeff
you.
Jeff says he really likes Heath and I.
We took care of him at Coachella.
Right, that's why. When you guys all left for the festival, we stayed back with Nerf.
Yeah, but I've been taking care of him like every day since Jeff has been with us.
Are we competing for Nerf?
I mean, I'm not competing for Nerf. He's
so old,
truth.
He has dementia, doesn't know who anybody is. Who's got treats? There's got to be another game we can play real quick.
No.
I'm into this.
I know, but Mariah's got to edit this.
Yeah, she does. She has to edit this tonight.
Oh, shit. Right.
Speak up, Mariah. Tell your truth. Tell your truth.
Whatever Speak you guys want to do.
All right, let's make this 3.5 hours. All right, let's go.
I'm on a contract. Yes. Yes.
She gets paid per episode. Doesn't matter how long it is.
Heath and I are like different when it comes to like something that we own. We feel bad. What do you want? What do you guys want? As long as you guys are happy.
But I'm so go with the flow. I'm like, sure, we'll do it at 12 o'clock.
I know.
Night.
We're all such go on the flow. Like whenever Matt needs to like get something done, we make sure like it just doesn't matter. I think it's because it's just so easy.
Yeah.
It's so, like we could do this whenever.
I want some pizza.
Ooh.
I'm gonna be honest with you.
I do want pizza crust ducked in garlic.
What's your favorite kind of pizza?
Pepperoni, but I would like an Alfredo chicken pizza style. But
he's feeling white pizza.
Yeah.
I'm a basic bitch, yo. I like cheese, just cheese.
No, you're not. You like fucking black olives.
Yeah. You guys have been making me feel bad about that shit, so I don't get it anymore. I just don't order anymore.
Weird.
I only get cheese now because like every time I get it, people are just like, "Oh, Zane, you get that?" And you guys make me feel
bad about it. Like ordering anchovy pizza. You order
no,
pizza.
It's not.
I ordered
like,
anchovy pizza.
No, you
it's like getting
didn't.
A supreme pizza.
A few months ago.
I'm sorry.
It stinks.
Have you guys ever had a breakfast slice?
Oh, with an egg on it?
Breakfast pizza's fire.
With an egg on it?
Sausage.
Taco pizza.
Taco
you ever had taco
is one
pizza?
Of my favorites.
I've yeah, never had that.
Mexican and Italian food is all the same. It's
canceled.
Wrapped a different
canceled.
Way.
What is a Mexican like, pasta? I've never heard of that.
No, I'm saying like you get a pizza. It's the same as a calzone. It's the same as a stromboli. It's just you wrap it with the same.
Oh,
it's the same.
That's what you mean.
You get a taco. Them individually. Right.
Yeah, right, right.
Yeah,
you get a taco or burrito, a chimichanga, an enchilada. It's all like it's.
Yeah.
It's
yeah.
But this Mexican version is more well known and people eat it more than the Italian
version. No, no,
no.
I'm saying like Italian is all the same thing.
Oh, yeah. I know.
Mexican is all the same thing.
Yeah.
But it's just like wrapped a different way, or something's just a little tweak.
Mariah, you know the whole like, you know, like Jersey Shore. You know how they eat like fucking 7 meals before they go out. Mm-hmm. Is that like a real thing? Do you guys like eat just a lot of fucking pasta, and you're able to like, move after that?
It's like the meal before the meal, then the meal before the meal. So you do like antipasta, and then you do the first course, and then second course,
that's
and
real.
Then dessert. Yeah.
Jesus, how do you like? Do you guys feel good after? Like you guys finish, you're like, yeah, let's go out.
Carbs, Heath, carbs is energy.
Like, not for me.
Like when I
die after.
For some reason, if I put like macaroni or cheese in my mouth, I'm bounce. I'm like,
dude,
second wind.
It's like if it, you get
it's my
if,
energy juice.
If you
it's
made her shotgun
weird.
A Red Bull, it's the same exact thing. She's just ready to go.
Nothing else gets me more wired than spaghetti.
I wish I was raised up with your family. God damn.
It's
I love
so
pasta,
weird.
But it kills me. It just fucking deteriorates me. It makes me feel like shit, and I don't want to do anything.
It
and
gets
like,
me
but,
so energized.
But carbs, what is it? Is it like carbs turn into sugars?
Yeah.
Something no, like no. That. Carbs turns into
what's right here.
Yeah, exactly. It just, that's all it does for me.
We should. Can we?
All right, man.
Oh, you know, Mariah, keep every time Matt does that, keep it in. Keep it in.
Well, fine. Then do keep it in. I just wanted to be able to talk to my girlfriend today. And she is in Alabama, and that's 2 hours ahead.
Oh, God. I feel cringe every time I have to end it because I don't like doing a whole outro for it. I like to just end shit.
All right, cool.
Bye, guys.
Yeah, let's do it.
Later.
Oh, really? Are we doing this?
Yeah,
fuck it.
All right,
guys. We love you. Thank you,
you
so much for always
it.
Watching. You know where to find it. We go Spotify, Apple. Back. You can find us on YouTube. All right. We love you guys.
Bye.
Bye. Mwah.
Bye, guys. Love you. Ooh.
Mwah.